Hi everyone, this is Veronica. Today we are going to talk about Sikkim. So Sikkim is also known as a window of Himalaya. So tourism industry is also boosting here. But today in this lecture, we will study about the political history of Sikkim, like how it transformed from Chogyal rule to Indian state. That is how it transformed from a monarchical state to a democratic state and emerged with India, acceded to India. So we'll discuss in detail about this issue. This is our channel StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam or pen drive and tablet, courses are also available. Now these courses have been prepared by top faculties of our channel. Now you can purchase them at ₹625 per month only. You can connect with me on Instagram and Facebook, because I feel together we can make a huge difference. Now, what is the relevance of this topic? In your mains paper 2, it will be covered under federalism. Objective level, you should know about the geography of Sikkim. Subjective level, at historical level, you should know about Sikkim's accession to India. Now, in what context today we are studying this? So this is a map of India. So this is the Sikkim. In Sikkim, recently 10 MLAs, in fact, have shifted their sides from opposition SDF. They have defected to BJP, adding to the political uncertainty that has loomed over since assembly elections. So this year, they delivered a fractured mandate. The current instability, it follows a unique event, the voting out of government in power for the first time in Sikkim's history. Since Sikkim has joined India in 1975, Sikkim has seen its government changed only twice. In both the cases, the government had fallen before the new one was voted in. Now, we will talk about why we are seeing here a departure from monarchy. Now, see, before 1975, Sikkim was ruled by Chogyal rulers and democratic rights were very limited. Analysts have described the current events as a departure from what has been called a monarchic psychology. The overall trajectory has been seen as being geared towards strengthening what is known as democracy. So they are saying that this is how the democracy is being strengthened in this state. Now, next we'll discuss about the Sikkim under the Chogyal rulers. For 333 years before 1975, Sikkim was ruled by Chogyals, or what is known as kings, of the Namgyal dynasty. I will write it here, Namgyal dynasty. So these were basically of Tibetan descent. According to one account, the first ruler, who was Penchu Namgyal, he was installed as king by Tibetan lamas in 1642. At its zenith, the Sikkim kingdom included your Chumbi Valley and Darjeeling. The former Chumbi Valley is now a part of China. After 1706, there was a series of conflicts between the powers of the region, which included Sikkim. So there was a conflict between the powers among various parts of the region. So the various parts, they include the areas of Sikkim, Nepal, Bhutan, and Tibet, resulting in a shrinking Sikkim's territorial boundaries. Now we will see what happened under British India. What differences British India made to Sikkim? How was their contact with British India? So we will start from 1814. Sikkim allied with East India Company in latter's campaign against Nepal. So Sikkim was already against Nepal. So British India noticed this thing and they took the benefit. They helped Sikkim fighting against Nepal. So after Company 1, it restored to Sikkim some of the territories that Nepal had wrested from it in 1780. In 1841, what happened? The company purchased Darjeeling from Namgyal rulers. A treaty in 1861 made Sikkim a de facto protectorate of British India. Subsequently, Calcutta Convention. So there was a convention known as Calcutta Convention. So of 1890, so this convention took place in 1890, it basically demarcated the border between Sikkim and Tibet, and was this Calcutta convention, it was signed by Viceroy Lord Lansdowne and King China's Imperial Associate resident in Tibet. So the Lhasa convention of 1904, it affirmed the Calcutta convention. So once again, this Calcutta convention was signed by Viceroy Lord Lansdowne and between King China's Imperial Associate resident in Tibet. So now, how Sikkim became a protectorate? After India became independent, so various events took place. India became independent in 1947. So a new relationship has to be started between New Delhi and Gangtok. It had to be redefined. So in 1950, a treaty was signed between Maharaja Tashi Namgyal and India's then political officer Sikkim Harishwar Dayal. The relationship between India and Sikkim was encapsulated in the clause that Sikkim shall continue to be a protectorate of India and subject to provision of this treaty shall enjoy autonomy in regard to its internal affairs. So this is how Sikkim became protectorate of India. But there was a continued struggle we keep on watching in Sikkim. In following decades, what happened, there was a gapping income equality. So here there was, what was there? Income inequality. If you see, even the largest revolution in the world started with this thing, income inequality, when it rises. So gapping income inequality and feudal control over the key resources led to the popular discontent against the Chogyal rulers. In December 1947, so we'll talk about December 1947. Diverse political groupings came together to form the Sikkim State Congress. So in 1947, Chogyal agreed to appoint a 5-member council of ministers. So 3 were Congress nominees and 2 of its own. Then in 1953, Chogyal introduced a new constitution and 4 general elections were held based on separate electorates. So these 4 elections were held in 1957, 1960, 1967, 1970. So plagued by distrust between the Chogyal rulers and the Congress, none of these elections actually helped to further strengthen the democracy. The protests were still seen. Now India comes into the play. Matters came to a head in 1973 when the royal palace was besieged by thousands of protesters. So Chogyal was left with no choice but to ask India to send troops for his assistance. Finally, a tripartite agreement was signed. So this agreement was between Chogyal, Indian government of India, that is the Indian government, and then your 3 major political parties of Sikkim, so that major political reforms could be introduced. Now, next in history was from a protectorate to full state, how Sikkim became a full state. So in 1974, elections were held in which Congress led by Kazi Lehendub Dorji emerged victorious over pro-independence parties. So in the same year, new constitution was also adopted, which restricted the role of Chogyal to a titular post. So it just remained as a title now. The Chogyal resented this and refused to deliver the customary address to elected assembly. So in the same year, India upgraded Sikkim status from protectorate to associated state. So what do we mean by associated state? That India allotted 1 seat in each Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha to Sikkim. But the King Chogyal, this Chogyal rulers were very unhappy with this move and they sought to internationalize the issue. So this did not go down well with Sikkim's elected leaders, and then a referendum was held. So a referendum finally. So referendum was held in 1975. So in this referendum, a total of 59,637 people voted in favor of abolishing the monarchy and joining India. And there were only like 1,496 votes which are against India, joining India. So subsequently what happened? India's parliament approved an amendment to make Sikkim a full state. Now this is how presently Sikkim looks. So just a little more prelims kind of booster things for you. So you should know in 16 May 1975, Sikkim became part of India. So all of you, you know Ajit Doval, his present National Security Advisor of India. So NSA Ajit Doval had played a prominent role in Sikkim's merger with India. Then in 2003, China acknowledged Sikkim as a part of India, because earlier there was a verbal understanding between India and China that Nepal, Bhutan and Sikkim will act as buffer states between India and China. So China was very angry when Sikkim merged with India. But in 2003, they also acknowledged Sikkim as a part of India. Sikkim is the only state to have the status of a co-state. So Sikkim is not a state, so it is known as a co-state in India. So Sikkim is the least populous state in India and the third largest peak in the world, that is Kanchenjunga. Is also in Sikkim. Tell me the height of this particular peak in the comment box. And the only road to China, that is Nathula Pass. Okay, it is also in Sikkim. So one more important thing here is that Sikkim was made part of India after 35th constitutional amendment and was made a co-state. So this is all about today's lecture. If you have any queries, you can contact me on Instagram, Facebook or Telegram. Thank you.